One of the common mistakes editors make when they first start using the DaVinci Resolve Speed Editor is not understanding which buttons have multiple secondary functions. And to answer the biggest example of this right off the bat, no, the search dial right here does not do anything when you click in on it. It's also hard to know which buttons work by double tapping them, a double tap and hold, or just a single tap and hold to use them properly. So today I'm going to show you all of the secondary modifier keys here on the Speed Editor and how to use them. To help you understand this better, I've broken the video down into three sections, each covering the three different types of button presses you need to know with the DaVinci Resolve Speed Editor. But also be sure to stick around to the end because I've got a great little bonus tip that you might not know about one way to use the split key. First up, let's run down this list of 10 double tap modifier functions. We're over here in DaVinci Resolve 17.1 today with some spray paint footage, but I first want to point out on the Speed Editor, if there's text down in front of a key, not just on top, you'll know there's a secondary modifier function for it. So first we're looking at the double tap ones. I'm going to start with Smart Insert. So if I go and pull my source up here on the timeline, we can see I have a clip that has an endpoint and an out point marked. And what the Smart Insert clip, if you look in front of there, it says clip does, is clip is going to ignore your endpoint and out point when you drop that into your timeline. So it's still going to do a Smart Insert, which is going to drop this clip into my timeline at that location of the smart indicator. But if I double tap it, it drops the entire clip, not just that marked region. So it's a way of ignoring your source in and out points. If I go back up to source again and I want to grab another clip and say, let's just say I had this section marked in and out right there on that clip, and I wanted to append edit, which means it goes to the very end of my timeline. Normally you would just hit this once to get that in and out point down there, but if you wanted the full clip, you would double tap it, and it gives you the entire clip down there on the timeline. So it's one way of like, hey, I want to see all the clips, all the material on one clip at once. You can do that with the clip function, which is a double tap with Smart Insert and Append. Now the next one on here is actually deals with your in and out point marks, and that is the clearing of your in and out points on these white keys right here. So if I go back up to my source and I want to clear this endpoint that had been marked, say it was marked right there, if I double tap it, it got rid of that. And you can see that's pretty simple. Same thing if we go here to clearing the out point. You double tap that and it's as easy as that. We've cleared all the in and out marks on that source tape. The next double tap function on here is going to be the set duration transition default button. That's sort of a mouthful. It's basically once you set your transition right here with this button, you hold this down, you can lock this in. Let's say I want it to be right at 1 second and you're still hovering over it. If you double tap it, it locks that into like the memory of the system so that every time I put a dissolve down after that, it's exactly 1 second, or it's whatever you had double tapped that transition at that point. So if I tap that down there, we know that that is now dropped down at exactly 1 second. We can check that if we hold this down and start to move this, it was indeed right at 1 second. If you've used computers for more than a couple minutes, you probably know about Command Z, which is undo. And on the Speed Editor, it's right underneath the escape button. It's a double tap of escape. And so, for example, let's say we have a dissolve down here and a dissolve right here, and we didn't actually want that to happen. We double tap escape and double tap escape, and it undoes those last two actions. Now, as we move across the keyboard, the next double tap function is gonna be mark. If we find a spot that we like on the timeline and we need to put a marker down for a note or something, we double tap it and it drops a marker down. What a lot of people don't know is if you double tap it again once it's down there, it brings up this markers contextual box so that you can make further notes right there without having to leave the Speed Editor, which is really handy. The next double tap function you gotta know is review. It's right underneath the full view button, the red one right here, double tap it. And this is just taking us to the very beginning of the sequence from the top down, and it's blown it up full screen so you can see everything in all its glory. If you need to get back to seeing the user interface again, just tap escape, okay, which is right there. And you can see where you're at. So that's a super useful one. Review, it's kind of like the home button, but full screen. The last double tap modifier I gotta show you here is underneath live overwrite, it's called random. If you double tap it and you've got the sync bin open, it is randomly going to drop any other clip down there starting at 5 seconds to sort of fill out your timeline. So if we had like 7 or 8 angles, it's gonna randomly choose one of those. As an editor, I take that as an insult. I wanna actually be choosing my angles, but it's there nonetheless, so I gotta show it to you. Now that we have the double tap functions all mastered, we can move on to the double tap and hold functions, which are really fun because these are the ones that we get to use the search dial with on the Speed Editor, which is really what makes the whole thing kind of special. But first, if you're new here to this channel, thank you so much for clicking and welcome. I'm Chadwick. This is Creative Video Tips, which is all about helping you create videos that make a difference and stand out. If that's something you're into and you haven't already done so, please click subscribe right down below right now so you don't miss out on the new tip next week. Now let's get back at it, and we're gonna learn the four double tap and hold functions and get to use that search dial. So the first double tap hold feature I wanna show you is slide. It's right underneath the roll button for trimming. If you double tap it real quick, like that, it'll select it, and then you can sort of move it around on the timeline and fine tune the in and out points of both the incoming and outcoming clip at once. If you need to know more about trimming, I have a video that'll link up right now that's all about trimming with the speed editor. The next double tap and hold modifier is actually mark. Mark is kind of special. This is the third time we're using mark for a modifier. If you double tap hold mark, it brings up this Wheel of Fortune sort of color wheel that we can choose any color from here. And if we choose that, that becomes the new default marker color. So if I double tap after that, that's the new default. And again, if I want to change the color, it's a double tap hold, use the search dial, and I want to make that green. It's green from that point on. The next double tap hold thing you want to check out is underneath the transition button. There's a title button. If you double tap hold that, you can use the search dial to scroll through all of your font family, font faces, and just get a different look really quickly and preview everything as fast as possible. And the last double tap hold one you're gonna use a lot, it's underneath snap, it's these three horizontal lines. Double tap hold, use the search dial, and you can enlarge and shrink in your viewer. And if you didn't know, in the interface here, it's basically mimicking this button right here. You can click and drag that with your mouse. But obviously, if you've got the speed editor, much faster to do this. And so you can make more room for your tracks or just see your viewer much larger. The last little modifier to add to your muscle memory is the tap and hold. And you actually already know this one if you've been using the trimming tools. It's just a simple smash down of that button and move the jog wheel, the search dial, at the same time. And the only two modifiers that use this one are move and the close-up button to adjust the Y position of a clip. So one of the tap and hold functions here is move. It's one of my favorite buttons on the speed editor. You just hold it down, hold down split, move is the secondary function to it. And we see we've got little arrows left and right with it. So if we take the search dial to the left, we're gonna move that entire clip in and out to the left. Move it to the right, it's gonna move it to the right. And this is gonna let us tweak and figure out what is the exact best order for us to tell our story. So maybe we want that shot to be the end of the sequence. That's how you do it with move. The final tap and hold modifier I wanna show you is the Y position for close up. So what close up does first, if you just tap close up and you've got a clip down on the timeline, it's going to punch in and basically make a close up of the shot underneath and put that up on track two. But what if the position that it chose isn't perfect? That's where you would do a tap and hold on this, and then it lets you change the up and down, the Y position of that clip. Now that you've mastered every single modifier here on the speed editor, there's a little bonus tip I recently learned about the split button and double tapping that I've just got to share. If you've seen my video on transitions, why cut doesn't cut, you know that split actually cuts a clip. But one thing a lot of people don't know is actually if you park right over a cut and hit split, it joins them back together. So I don't know if you saw that. If I have this cut, and it's basically, it's a through edit, so the edits are the same left and right of the timeline, and I hit split again, it joins those right back together. I found that super useful because then when I go to the color page and other areas where I need to send it out, it's less cuts that are on the timeline that are unnecessary. If you found this video useful or helpful at all, please tap the like button. That's the thumbs up one. Just don't double tap it or it's not gonna count. And if you'd like to learn more about using the speed editor or DaVinci Resolve in general, I have the perfect playlist for you popping up right now. And since there's so much more to learn, I'll see you over in that next video.